When we meet her, she's quite desirous of connecting with him in particular, and just relating with anyone, but especially him, because she remembers him very fondly from their days when they fought in the war. And he was their leader, so he kind of provided some sense of order and security for her. And over the, you know, Maggie and I talked a lot about what had happened in the preceding years and how did that evolve in her mind into what in her mind is love. Vampires prey on the blood of mammals and they are photosensitive, so they have to stay out of the light. So they've evolved without eyes, they have extraordinary sense of hearing and smell, and they're quite dexterous. They move in really unpredictable ways and really, really, really fast. Most of the hives were liquidated after the war, and that the remaining, you know, vampire drones were principally put on reservations, basically in prison camps. So Solomira is one particular hive, one of the largest ones, and it's where Hicks and Priest go in their effort to track down the vampires that took Lucy. They go to the hive, and when they get there in the middle of the story, they find a hive that appears to be long since abandoned and kind of consumed by the desert and dry. And of course, as they start to move through the hive, they end up finding something that feels a lot fresher.